Hi, let's start regular expression. An expression which is constructed over using operator clean closure, concatenation or you can say union is called as regular expression. A regular expression can be described as sequence of pattern that define a string. Regular expression are used to match character combination in string. By which combination you are forming that string that can be represented by regular expression. It is used in compiler, interpreter, testing tool, searching, test editor, and pattern recognition. Every regular expression generates only one regular language, but regular language can have more than one regular expression. In short, you can say regular expression is not unique. There can be more than one regular expression for one regular language. The language generated by regular expression is accepted by some finite automata and is regular language. Regular operator, mainly there are three operator. Clean closure. Clean closure means zero or any repetition. I already discussed what is clean closure. Then this is concatenation. Then concat two regular expression. Then plus or in some book you will see union symbol. This is for union, or you can say or. When plus is between two operand, that is for union or. When plus is written as a superscript, this is as a positive closure. If R1 and R2 two regular expression, then R1 plus R2 clean closure, you can write as R1 clean closure plus R2 whole clean closure, or you can write as R1 plus R2 clean closure whole clean closure, or you can write R1 clean closure plus R2 clean closure whole clean closure, or you can write R1 closure concatenation R2 closure whole clean closure. All are equal. You can write in any form. Question will come like this. There will be some regular expression given. It will ask which regular expression are equal. So these are all equal. R1 plus R2 clean closure, that you can write as R1 closure concatenation R2 closure whole closure. Suppose this will be epsilon, then you can use R1. If this will be epsilon, then you can use R2. Which string you can generate by this, that same string you can also generate by this. This is important, just remember this. R1, then R2 concatenation R1 clean closure, that you can write as R1 concatenation R2 whole clean closure R1. It is a shifting rule. We just shift the bracket. This is called as a shifting rule. Two regular expression are equal if language of regular expression 1 equal to language of regular expression 2. If language is equal for both regular expression, then two regular expression are equal. If R equal to phi, then R clean closure will be epsilon and R positive closure will be phi. If R equal to epsilon, then R clean closure will be epsilon and R positive closure will be epsilon. So R clean closure, that is an infinite language except for R equal to phi or R equal to epsilon. When R equal to phi, then R clean closure will be epsilon, so it will be finite. And when R equal to epsilon, then its clean closure will be epsilon and it will be finite. It just contain one string, that's why it will be finite. Except these two, R clean closure will be infinite. Let's simplify some regular expression. Zero closure plus epsilon, then whole closure, that you can write as zero closure. Because from zero closure you can generate epsilon. Zero closure means it will be epsilon, then single zero, then two zero, three zero, any number of zero. From this you can generate epsilon, so you can just write zero closure. Then zero closure, zero, whole closure. So zero closure concatenation of zero, that will be zero plus. Zero closure means it will be epsilon, then single zero, then zero zero, then three zero, like this. That will concatenate with zero. So zero will be concatenate with all. It will generate zero, then it will generate zero zero, then three zero, then four zero, like this. So you can write this will be zero plus. Zero clean closure concatenation zero, that will be zero plus. Then zero plus clean closure, that will be zero clean closure. Then zero clean closure one plus one, then whole clean closure. You can mark this one, you can generate from this string. When zero closure will be epsilon, you can generate simply one. So this can be part of this. So you can just write 0 closure 1 whole closure. You don't need to write this one. It's just like this. Here from 0 star epsilon can be generated. Here from 0 closure 1, 1 can be generated. So don't need to write this. You can just write 0 closure 1 whole closure. 0 closure 1 plus 1 0 closure whole closure. If you write 0 closure 1 0 closure, then from this you can generate 0 closure 1 when this 0 star will be epsilon. Then you can generate 1 0 closure when this 0 closure will be epsilon. So from 0 closure 1 0 closure you can generate both the string. So that's why you can write 0 star 1 plus 1 0 star as 0 closure 1 0 closure. And here whole closure is there. Here also you will write whole closure. Here this is a positive closure. This plus means it is or union. This plus means it is positive closure. 0 closure plus 1 positive closure. Then 0 clean closure. Whole closure plus 1 0 whole closure. This 0 closure you can write as epsilon concat 0 closure. Then here it is same. 1 positive closure 0 closure. And this is same. Now from these two you can take 0 closure as a common. Let's take 0 closure as a common. Then it will be epsilon plus 1 positive closure. And here 1 0 whole star. Now what will be this value 1 plus, that will be single 1, 2 1, 3 1, any number of 1. And here 1 epsilon. This is 1 positive closure plus epsilon, that will be 1 clean closure. Now this will be 1 clean closure. Then 0 closure was before, then whole closure, and this is 1 0 whole closure. 1 closure 0 closure, that you can write 1 plus 0 whole closure. I discuss as a R1 plus R2 whole closure, that you can write as R1 closure concatenation R2 closure, then bracket whole closure. I already discussed that R1 plus R2 whole closure, that is equal to R1 closure concatenation R2 closure whole closure. So here in place of this we can write 1 plus 0 whole closure, and here 1 0 closure will be same. Now we got 1 plus 0 whole closure, and this is our universal language. From this we can represent all the string, even we can represent 1 0 whole closure. This 1 0 whole closure means you can get epsilon, you can get 1 0, then you can get 1 0 1 0. So this thing also you can generate from 1 plus 0 whole closure. 1 plus 0 whole closure, that is our universal language, that can represent any string of 1 and 0. This also can be generated from this. Okay, so that's how you can write 1 plus 0 whole closure. After simplification we are getting 1 plus 0 whole closure, or you can say this is our universal language. If L1 equal to phi, L2 equal to epsilon, L3 equal to A, then L1 clean closure will be epsilon, then L2 clean closure will be epsilon, phi clean closure will be epsilon. So here L1 clean closure will be epsilon, L2 clean closure will be epsilon, then L3 clean closure, L3 is A closure, A clean closure. Now L1 concatenation, L2 clean closure, L1 is phi, L2 is epsilon, phi concatenation epsilon, then whole clean closure. Phi concatenation with anything, that will be phi itself, so it will be phi, then here clean closure, phi clean closure will be epsilon. Now L1 L3 closure plus L1 closure, this was asked in previous question. It was asked in GATE 2013. It was question number 8. L1 is phi, L3 is A, so phi A closure plus here L1 is phi closure will be epsilon, so here plus epsilon. Now phi concatenation with anything, that will be phi plus epsilon, or phi union epsilon, so it will be epsilon. Then L2 concatenation L3 clean closure concatenation L1, L2 is epsilon, L3 is A, so epsilon concatenation A, then whole clean closure concatenation L1. What is L1? L1 is phi. So epsilon concat A, that will be A closure concat phi. So phi concatenation with anything, that will be phi itself. So answer will be phi. L1 closure concat L2 closure plus L3 whole closure. L1 is phi, phi closure, then L2 is epsilon, here epsilon closure will be epsilon, plus L3 is A, then whole closure. So phi closure will be epsilon, then epsilon plus A, that will be A, and here is closure, so A closure, phi concatenation A closure, that will be A closure. Phi clean closure will be epsilon, phi concatenation with anything, that will be phi. Just remember that, you can simplify. Let's solve one question. Which of the following regular expression are identical? There are four regular expression: A closure, then A whole closure, then A plus epsilon, then A closure, A closure. So here this is any number of A, this is even number of A, and this is odd number of A. Option 4, that is odd number of A. Option 2, that is even number of A. Option 1, that is any number of A. Let's simplify option 3. Here A plus epsilon, then A clean closure. Now I'll just concat A concatenation A closure, that will be A plus, then epsilon concatenation A closure, that will be A closure. Now A positive closure plus A clean closure, that will be A clean closure. It's just like multiplication, A multiplied by A star, that will be A plus, then epsilon multiplied by A star, that will be A clean closure. Both union will be A clean closure. After simplification of option 3, we are getting option 1, that is A clean closure. So you can say option 3 and option 1 are same, or you can say A clean closure, that is equal to A plus epsilon whole bracket, then A closure. So both are equal. If any doubt, just ask me in comment. Thank you.